At the start of the door, the sitar sounding guitar, it looks like a guitar, but when you play it, I don't know how it's achieved, but it sounds like a sitar. I think there's a couple of Silverchair songs with sitar, actually. I do recall a sitar player coming into the studio, maybe Petrol and Chlorine. I don't know, there's definitely a song with sitar on it. The original title for The Door, I think it was the Poxy song, because we weren't initially fans of it. It kind of had to, even within the band, it really had to grow on us, you know? But I think management were like, nah, we really like this song. It's got a bounce and a bop to it. And yeah, so over time it just grew on us. The Door is another example of a Silverchair track, which would probably sound very different, way less fluid, if we used a metronome. The subtle fluctuations in tempo made it hard to play along precisely with the original recording, but it's what gives this track and plenty of other Silverchair tracks the true Silverchair feel. Taking inspiration from my drumming idol, John Bonham, my goal for this track is to deliver a solid drum entry that commands attention. All snare, almost like I'm announcing my presence in the room. It's worth noting that the intro serves as a great example of Silverchair's tendency not to use click tracks. I'm not entirely sure of the tempo, but it feels like it speeds up slightly once the drums kick in. But as the initial excitement wears off, the rhythm settles into a comfortable groove. Given that the guitar and bass are playing open chords and the vocals are floating above, it's important for the overall drum track to be solid and provide a strong rhythmic foundation. However, during this washy chorus section, you may notice some subtle fills that I've added. Those fills provide something else for the listener's rhythmic ear to latch onto. Have I mentioned groove? Ultimately, it's the groove and solid drum foundation that gives this song weight, because without it, there's little to grab onto. And you'll notice during the outro that I continue using fills as rhythmic ear hooks, but I turn up the frequency and intensity to match the crescendo at the end of the track.